There's a crack in the black sky. It's starting to pour. He'll fall in the night. Water on the rise. Can't do nothing but pray at this point. Make God survive if you make it out alive. Gonna be a new man crawling out the other side. Baptized by the river. Baptized by the river. Mississippi mud, baptized by the river, yeah. In the middle of a thunderstorm. Heavy lightning striking, the shore's on fire. Struggle for your soul. Feels out of your control as the water keeps getting higher. So you close your eyes and you fight to find the strength that keeps swimming up toward the light. Baptized by the river. Baptized by the river. By the river, baptized by the river. Black water rolling by, oh my soul, now I'm washed in the blood away with the blood and the sins of my way. Think it's Mississippi mud, baptized by the river.
Jacob Bryant, welcome to the Print Shop, man.
Thanks for having me, bro.
Thanks for coming, man. We've had an absolute blast today. Every episode is different, and we just keep growing this thing with just, it seems like one act just outdoes the next in terms of talent, coolness, and you guys certainly kept that that going in the right trajectory, man.
I don't know about that, but we definitely make things interesting.
I'm telling you, man, you and I've gotten to know each other, you know, throughout the day today. That's one of the coolest things I like about this show is that, you know, I feel like it creates a little bit of comfort coming into someone's home. It's a different kind of gig.
Absolutely.
Right? Have you ever done anything like this?
No, absolutely not. Never played golf in somebody's yard before. Right? So, yeah, that was pretty cool.
That was fun. When you guys rolled up, you rolled up in a full tour bus. And a trailer in a cul-de-sac, and I was like, "We're gonna have some trouble here."
Hey, Jimbo's got us out of worse situations.
Dude,
so.
It was impressive. We figured it out. Let's jump into some of the history of Jacob Bryant. You're a Georgia boy, like myself.
Born and raised Jasper,
Jasper, Georgia.
Yeah.
So you grew up playing bluegrass music, is that right?
Yeah, bluegrass, a little bit of gospel back then, and pretty much anything on the spectrum of grass and old country and southern rock. I mean, Georgia. I mean,
right.
Greg Allman, Skinner, Travis Tritt. I mean, right down the road, of course. But, you know, it's it's just a Southern sound. I mean, I just call it Southern music.
Yeah.
You know, that's what my music is.
Down dirty bar, as I stumbled off the stage, this old man grabbed my guitar. He said, "Son, I'm glad I caught your show. I really dig your sound, but you may never get your chance if you don't slow down." He said, "I'm hyped up on the cocaine, whiskey, fame, no pain. Need a handful of pills just to get back down. Apple." Bullet loaded pistol scares off all the demons. Every time they come around, I lost track of all the women. Can't get back what I've been spending. That's just the cost of living. I'd always known him, even though we'd never met. There was something so familiar, that old six string in his hand. But then his words cut through the smoke. He said, "I understand, but I'm hyped up on the cocaine. Whiskey feeling no pain. Need a handful of pills just to get back down. Have a bottle of George Dickel. Every time they come around, I've lost track of all the women. Can't get back what I've been spending. That's just the cost of living. That man, he said, "Hoss Lord, this outlaw bit can sure get out of hand. You're hyped up on the cocaine, whiskey, feeling no pain. Need a handful of pills just to get back down. Half a bottle of George Dickel, bullet loaded pistol scares off all the demons. Every time they come around, I've lost track of all."
Start playing music.
Yeah, I mean, I played guitar from the time I was 8.
Oh, really?
Till now.
That's a family thing.
Yeah. My grandparents had a bluegrass band, and they played every weekend on the front porch, and you know, everybody's drinking, you know, adult beverages and having a good time. But man, it was just one of them things that's always been ingrained in me. Music was. And
when did you get your first guitar? Guitar that you own?
8.
8 years old.
8, yeah.
You're like, "Jacob, this is yours."
Yeah, Dad, me and Dad were in, I think we were in Florida somewhere. We went in a pawn shop. And it was kind of funny that I ended up being more of an acoustic guy, but he bought me like a little Yamaha electric at a pawn shop. And Dad was saying, like on the way home, which I don't remember this, of course, but Dad was saying on the way, you know, back from Florida to Georgia, that he remembers hearing me like play along to the radio. And like I was, because I still play by ear, I've never read a lick of music whatsoever.
Really?
But he said he remembers me like playing along with the radio within like a couple days of having it on the way home or whatever. So it's a pretty cool story. Like you just, Dad was like, hey, you want a guitar? Cool, all right, here, whatever. And then here we are. So it's pretty cool.
How long have you been out playing music, you know, as a profession, like making a living at music?
Man, I can't call it a profession when I started making music or making money doing it. It was one of those things. Like, I'd go do a $100 acoustic gig or something like that on the weekends. But I guess probably 2014, when I met my manager, Jeff, that was, I guess, when I actually did it for a living, you know? We put out some EPs and started getting stuff on streaming platforms, Spotify, Apple Music, Pandora. At that time, iTunes, you know, where they actually buy the music, you know, that's the thing that's kind of fizzling out. I guess 2014 is when I really 100% like went all in and said, I'm in it. But even before that, I was playing gigs and, you know, kind of weekend warrior in it, you know, thing. But yeah, 2014.
One of my favorite songs, and I know this is a massive song for you, probably one of your biggest, is Pour Whiskey on My Grave. And you've probably been asked about it 1,000 times, but you're here and I'd like to ask
you
about
it.
It's a hell of a video. It's probably my favorite video that you had. Probably one of my favorite songs that you've done. Where'd that song come from?
That one, I wish I would have wrote it, but I actually didn't. I was actually at a songwriter's night or whatever, and in Nashville we were playing Tin Roof Revival thing. Mm-hmm. And a friend of mine, Jake Worthington, was there, and a couple other people. Well, this dude named Jamie Grooms was sitting to the left of me in this round. Everybody plays like one song, and then I play a song, and blah, 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 all the way around. Well, his last song, it goes off into that. When I'm gone, don't bring me pretty flowers. And I was like, why ain't nobody wrote this yet, you know, or whatever. And then sure enough, gets to the next part, Pour Whiskey on My Grave, all this stuff. And after my mom passed away, I always go over there on her birthday, and she passed away on New Year's. So sometimes I go over there on New Year's and I'll pour a beer out and drink one with her, but she was my drinking buddy.
Really?
But yeah. But anyway, so like, it was just one of them tunes, and I remember Jeff was in the crowd, and I looked at Jeff and in disbelief, and I was like, this is my song. Like, we have to get this song. And I remember telling him, like, get this song. So after the show, Jeff and Jamie hooked up or whatever, and we ended up getting the license to cut it and everything. And now, I mean, me and Jamie wrote 10, 20 songs or whatever. Me and Jamie wrote Practice What I Preach, which ended up being the, you know, title of the record and all that stuff. But that tune was just one of those that, like, I couldn't believe I didn't write it. It was like almost one of those, like, I wanted to go smack myself, because it's like, I already do it. Why didn't I? But Jamie wrote it, and sometimes that's one of the things that just fell right in your lap, you know, like, you just gotta, when God lays it on you, you just get it and roll with it, you know. So we went ahead and cut it, and man, it's been crazy how responsive that thing's been. It's nuts.
When I'm gone, don't bring me pretty flowers, and don't sit and cry for me, my tombstone. Just come and visit me in midnight hours with your party on. Just think of me, recall all the good times. Bring your memories in a bottle of old gin. Let's take a swing of the haunted honky tonk moonshines. Remember me and pour whiskey on my grave. Let it seep into my bones. Have a drink with me, even when I'm gone. I'll do the same for you. If you'll do the same for me, let's turn it up and take a shot. Set my spirit free. But don't forget that the promise that you made. Y'all pour whiskey on my grave. My time's up, don't let the good times be gone. Let me still go out like I wanted to go. kicking it up and drinking with my boots on, with a rebel soul. And put whiskey on my tray, then it's seep into my bones. I have a drink with me, even when I'm gone. I'll do the same for you, if you'll do the same for me. Let's turn it up and take a shot, set my spirit free. But don't forget the promise that you made. Y'all pour whiskey on my grave. When I'm gone, don't bring me pretty flowers, and don't shed a tear for me, my tombstone. Just come and visit me in the midnight hours with your party on.
Outside looking in, I look at you as an independent artist. You're very strong on socials. You've got fantastic music. Obviously, there's a lot of engagement and a lot of fans that are coming. So, do you feel like you need to be on a major record label to get this thing done? Is that your goal, or do you feel like I'm going to be this independent guy that's going to make it work?
When I first started music, and like I started, you know, especially like traveling to Nashville and writing with people, I met a gal named Bridget Tatum that wrote She's Country for Al Dean, and Danny Myrick that's, you know, on that, and a couple of the songs. Anyway, long story short, like, I looked up to them. Like, it was about the song for me. It's never been about get rich quick, get a record deal, and let's tour the country and act like a rock star. Like, I don't care. Grew up in a single wide trailer, lived in it till last year. You know, even when I had a bus, I was still living in a single wide. So, like, none of the money part has never mattered. It's just, they're, in my opinion, there has to be something in it for me, passion-wise, that my heart tells me that's what you should be doing. And I just haven't had that deal on the table yet. We've had deals come in, and Jeff can attest to this. You know, we've met some incredible people at multiple labels, and it just wasn't the right thing, you know. And I'm just not gonna, you know, sign up for somebody and or something that's not me, you know. If they're not going to let Jacob be Jacob, then what's the point? Yeah. You know, so I'm not in any hurry to do it. Am I saying I won't ever? Absolutely not. Probably will at some point. But my buddy Cody Johnson, I mean, look at him. I mean, he was selling out arenas in Houston Rodeo before he ever even signed a record deal. So it's like, I'm not worried about it, to be honest with you. I'm not even thinking about it. My goal is to write incredible songs, surround myself with incredible people, tour my ass off, work my ass off, and take care of my daughter at this point. You know, I'm not worried about the machine, you know. So,
hey man, well said. Yeah. I like that.
Spoon. Uncle Tom will take a talk or two just to pass the time. He'd make a back porch altar call and break out that mason jar. Throw me that old guitar, we'll go to church a while. And he'd say, gather around my congregation, for yeah, this world has gone crazy, but no, that ain't changing me. I got my Bible, guns and whiskey. Hell else do you need? Oh, I ain't talking just to hear myself speak. I practice what I preach. Everybody mind their business, stop peeping over people's fences and worried about what's offensive, and just mind their own. I like sleeping knowing I can leave my front door open, cause yeah, my shotgun's loaded, just try me some. Yeah, this world has gone crazy, no, that ain't changing. This world has gone crazy, no, that ain't changing a thing. I know I got my Bible, guns and whiskey, but hell else do we need? Oh, I ain't talking just to hear myself speak. I practice what I preach. Yeah.
Thank you,
the way that I met you guys or got hooked up with you guys is through Jesse Triplett of Collective Soul. Yeah. Collective Soul recently did our show. Mm-hmm. And Jesse is one heck of a guy. We were talking just outside here and he said, man, you got to call my boy Jacob. Mm-hmm. He said, I think he'd fit in really well over here. I think you'd really like him. And I got to be honest, that was the first time I really started digging into your music. I'd heard a couple of your tunes, but over the last couple of weeks, I've really just dug in. And it's one of those things where, how the hell did I miss this, you know? Some of your tracks, they're just so rock, you know, oriented. And I really like that sentiment behind it all, that driving force of those big guitars. And your voice, you got one hell of a voice, man. Country Went to Hell. Now, that's a title that will get your attention.
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
That one, that's one of them tunes, man. I mean, it's talking about Cash and Waylon and a lot of them guys. It's just straight up Waylon style, just, you know, country.
Oh, yeah.
I gravitate toward them songs that are a little bit edgy and might piss people off a little bit, you know, or whatever. But, like, at the end of the day, we can only eat so much of GD, E minor C, baby girl, truck bed, bonfire, blah, 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 over and over. You know, it got to the point where I was like, man, somebody's got to say something. So that one, my buddy Davey Smith in Chattanooga, he had wrote that song, and that was another one I ended up being able to cut an outside track. But it was just one of them things, man. It's just something that needed to be said. I mean, Eric Church has a song out right now. It's called Stick That in Your Country Song. Mm-hmm. You need to go look it up.
Really?
It's talking about, you know, all the rioting and all that stuff. And he's like, why don't you put that in a country song? Why don't you talk about the teacher that gets the crap beat out of her by a kid and comes home and smiles every night? Or why don't you talk about the dude that went to war and now he has PTSD and all this stuff? Like, I get, like, happy-go-lucky stuff, but at the end of the day, like, country music was founded on the real.
My grandma bought me this guitar on the day that I turned 9. Well, I stand in front of the mirror and act like I could play I Walk the Line. My daddy's car the first time I heard Waylon Jennings sing, saying it don't matter who's in Texas halls, Bob Wills is still the king. And we've come a long way since folks shook in that good time in Maine. If Johnny and you went to Jackson over Nashville, they'd want my long back. And I remember the day the good Lord called Johnny Payton home. That's when country went to hell, and now the man in black is gone. Go ahead, Jacob. Record from Branded Man to Yesterday's Wine. And I knew just what he was talking about when he told us how much his mama tried. Lord, if the apostle ask us all, Lordy, who's gonna fill them shoes? Well, Mr. Jones, I'm afraid I'm sorry. I think I got a little bad news. Yeah, we've come a long way since folks up in that good time in Maine. Yeah, Johnny and you went to Jackson over Nashville, then on my outlaw band. And I remember the day the good Lord called Waylon Jennings home. That's when country went to hell. Now the man in black is gone. Come on, Jim. remember the day the good Lord called Keith Whitley home. Last week country went to hell, and now the man in black is gone. Let's count it down for Mr. Castle.
This Side of Sober. Well, tell me a little bit about that. Like, what
that one, man, that song saved my life.
Really? That's a bold statement.
Yes, the truth. There's a guy named Joel Shoemake that wrote that tune, which also became a friend of mine. Going back to everything coming full circle, and God puts people in your life and whatever. Anyway, he had wrote this tune, and there was a couple other artists that had done a version of it, and I had heard it on YouTube. And I don't know, man, like I heard it, and I was like, man, I was like, something's speaking to me. I got to do something with this. I'm kind of similar to Poor Whiskey, and that's the only two times that's ever happened where it was like almost like something telling me, like, you got to go cut this. Somebody needs to hear this, and it's your job to go do it. You know, and we had spoke about this earlier. I mean, I consider myself a barstool preacher. I'll sit there and drink a beer with you or whatever, but I'll also sit there and talk about God to you, you know, because I ain't perfect. You know, he didn't die on the cross for all of us to be perfect. He died because we're all sinners, and he just wants us to try to be better every day. But that particular tune, at the time and the place I was in, you know, like there was some times in my life where, you know, I remember waking up and not even being able to get to the refrigerator fast enough because I'm shaking so bad, and try to get more alcohol in me or whatever. And you know, to this day, it's very weird to me that I even beat it, because I never thought I would. I didn't think I'd even make it to 30 years old. You know, and now I got a baby girl and a wife, and everything's great. But it's that's just one of them tunes, man. It just opened my eyes, and I was like, man, you gotta grow up. You gotta get your shit together, Maybe it was just that tune that made me say, hey, this other dude that's going through exactly what you're going through needs to hear this too. You know, so then when I started doing that, I mean, it ended up with like 21 million views or some crazy stuff. Wow. Went viral on Facebook twice. And yeah, man, that one is, to me, will always probably be my favorite song I've ever recorded.
Hey, mister, can you tell me how far a walk it is to the nearest bar, so I can turn around and run the other way? I've got a tendency to tie one on. If stupid was a shirt, my sleeves would be long. I'm never too far from making my next mistake, because it's hard to outrun the devil when he's sitting on your shoulder. And you can't feel the warmer side of life when your world's getting colder. You know I'm gonna be a better man for it when my dark days are over. But it's hard to see the light at the end of the tunnel inside sober. And he said, yeah, I'm a God-fearing, hard-working man. Put some Jim Beam in my hand. And I'm a backslider, dying down a dead-end road. It all started with my first sip of beer, and saw a blur I got from there to here. And 12 steps feels like a million more miles to go. It's hard to outrun the devil when he's sitting on your shoulder. And you can't feel the warmer side of life when your world's getting colder. You know I'm gonna be a better man for it when my dark days are over. But it's hard to see the light at the end of the tunnel inside sober. Well, I paid for the coffee, stepped out into the night, and he said, if I can just make it home, today would make 29. Yeah. shoulder. You can't feel the warmer side of life when your world's getting colder. You know I'm gonna be a better man for it when my dark days are over. But it's hard to see the light at the end of the tunnel this time. Can you tell me how far a walk it is to the nearest bar, so I can turn around and run the other way? Yeah. A song called Sober.
The best singer of all time, in my opinion, is Keith Whitley.
Yeah.
Or George Jones. It's a tight.
It was
race, but.
They're fantastic. Keith Whitley, you know, unfortunately wasn't with us a whole lot. Who could imagine what he could have done with his career? I think what did he do? One or two records only?
Man, honest with you, I don't know how many he did. I actually became friends with his son, Jesse Keith Whitley, and me and him are like brothers. But we were talking about it, man, and like his dad has so many, you know, still to this day, so many tracks that people's never even heard, and mm-hmm. and songs, and you know, all this merch and stuff. And Jesse, actually being my brother, it probably choked me up, but he knew how much I loved Keith, you know. And you can't get like Keith merch anymore, like real authentic merch. Like there's people that print Keith Whitley stuff all the time, but he brought me like an actual Keith Whitley pick that from the tour, you know, and it's still in my safe today. And like, that's one of those things, man, like you meet these people and it's weird how God puts you in a weird kind of conundrum of things when you think like, oh man, Keith Whitley's my guy, and then all of a sudden you know his son, and then all of a sudden I'm working with all these crazy, like talented, incredible people and stuff, man. And it's one of the things, like dreamers need to dream, man. And that's what I'm very passionate about working with you. I've offset, of course, me and you had a lot of talks about a lot of things about entrepreneurship and, mm-hmm. and working, man. I'm excited to know you.
So you're a new father.
Absolutely. Yeah. Should be one on the 20th.
And I'm envious of that. Paul has a young daughter as well, and I enjoy spending time with them just because, I mean, I love my daughter. She's 16 now, but the time flies so much, man. So you're in for a huge treat, man. You already are, but I just know what's to come.
I'm
I know
scared.
What's to come. Best part of me. I love that, too. Mm. Tell me a little bit of the best part of me.
That's about my wife, Brittany, yeah. There's a line in there that, you know, basically says she's the water and the fire and the cigarette and the cap to the whiskey when I can't quit, and you know, talking about addiction and things like that. You know, she never tried to, you know, change me or tell me I was doing something wrong or whatever. She was just there for me, and it made me want to help myself, you know. And that was that song.
Been a month Sunday since I sat in that back pew. Just a rusty vessel that might need a word or two. I can't count the times I've counted on you. Hear the foot on the brake when I'm going too fast. Cut to the fuse before it all goes bad. The voice in my head telling me not to. Hear the pop to the fire in this cigarette. Count to the whiskey when I can't quit. Baby girl, you ain't got a clue. The best part of me is you. I said a lie. should fit my tongue. I got so much baggage, I can't even close my trunk. But it's a damn good thing you're here to hold on to. Hear the foot on the brake when going too fast. Cut to the view before it all goes bad. The voice in my head telling me not to. Hear the water to the fire and this cigarette. Count to the whiskey and I can't quit. Baby girl, you ain't got a clue. Best part of me is you. Telling me not to. You're the water to the fire in this cigarette. Cap to the whiskey when I can't quit. Baby girl, you ain't got a clue. Oh baby girl, you ain't got a clue. Best part of me is you. Best part.
Let's talk about the future.
Yeah.
What do you got going on right now? You recording some new music?
Yeah. We've cut 25 tracks. We're thinking about doing like a white and black album, like Metallica kind of thing or whatever, and do like a 12 and 12 or something like that. Maybe I don't know. It's just kind of an idea at this point. But we got a lot of cool stuff. Jesse, he's got an incredible mind as far as like.
Wait. Jesse has an incredible mind. Is that what you said?
Well, when he's drinking Tito's, yeah.
No, he does have an incredible mind.
No, he's great, man. He's brought a lot of things that I've thought were cool, and he's taken them to a whole nother level. And it's like, oh wow, like he brought it alive and made everything kind of pop. So it's gonna be fun. I don't know when it'll come out. It's one of them things, like I said, we got 25 cut, and we'll probably even cut 10 more before we decide what, the final track list will be. But at this point, we're just trying to stay creative, stay in the studio, write a lot, and surround ourselves with good people, and rock on with it.
So I got a request.
What do you got?
Mind playing us the new song?
Yeah, I can do it. If I can remember how.
So this is a premiere for this song. Is that correct?
Yeah, I've never played this live. Actually, I've only played it once, which was earlier.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
All right. We'll just keep the cameras rolling. This is gonna be good, guys.
But when I was getting into writing and stuff in Nashville, pretty heavy in the past couple of years, I met a couple guys. A dude named Wyatt McCubbin. Is a dude you should probably get in here. I don't think I know another songwriter in today's world that's better than this guy. Like, wow. he's incredible. But anyway, it's a tune he wrote called Buzzards. So hope you like it.
Yeah, I knew some. Shadows on the ground. Feels like I ought to be in some old out west town. They're circling overhead, and it's all starting to make sense. Why you can't look me in the eye and tell me where you've been? Yeah, I see buzzers like they know something I don't. Girl, they're giving you away. Saying everything you want. If they're waiting round for us to die, there won't be nothing left. Cause when love is gone, it's gone. And yet, man, these damn birds are gonna starve to death.
must know you, and hell, we must know them. You've told them that you're leaving, they just smell it on the wind. Yeah, they're blocking out the sun, but girl, you know that I ain't blind. I can see a goodbye coming, but I appreciate the warning sign. I see buzzers like they know something I don't. Girl, they're giving you away, saying everything you want. If they're waiting round for us to die, there won't be nothing left. Cause when love is gone, it's gone. And yeah, man, these damn birds are gonna starve to death. This one horse town, we both know it's over, they'd be long gone by now. Yeah, I see buzzards like they know something I don't. But they're giving you away, saying everything you want. If they're waiting round for us to die, there won't be nothing left. When love is gone, it's gone. And yet, man, these damn birds are gonna starve to death. Flub up and all, but
yeah.
Hey, like I said, I ain't never played it live, so
my man.
I'd rather it be raw and real though, so we ain't gonna retake it.
You heard it here first. Jacob Bryant, man, you are a real, unapologetic, awesome dude, man.
Thank you, man.
I wish you nothing but the best. And I think big things are gonna happen for you. And I can't wait to watch it happen, unfold.
Hey, we'll watch it together.
Thanks for coming to the print shop,
absolutely,
man.
God, hey, over.
That's up. I mean, I knew. I hate that.
Here you go, Jacob Bryant, live in the press shop.
There it is.
Show mode.
Let's do this. Jacob Bryant.
How you doing?
Welcome to the Bread Shop, man. Hey, let's start that over. I was my mouth got caught on my teeth.
Pass it over to
it.
So
we'll just do this and just moose knuckle it.
Yeah, there we go. Do that. Oh, yeah,
tread,
if you gotta go. Hold on a second.
Treading water.
I hate that. It's been with me the
That's
whole
a
time,
rat.
Man. Short. I got like T-Rex arms and short legs. It's, I don't need a big chair like that. That chair.